My name is Josh, and I'm from Murrieta, California. I was diagnosed HIV positive in June of 2012 and started antiretroviral therapy shortly after. Within a month of being diagnosed, I achieved an undetectable viral load, which I maintained to the present date through daily adherence to my HIV medication. You see, when I was first diagnosed, I was scared to have sex. I felt dirty inside. My fear of transmission to someone else always lingered in my mind, and it caused me to go into a state of isolation, triggering my depression. Despite the medical advancements, my own personal work in HIV advocacy, and the scientific research being released at the time on treatment as prevention, what we also know as TaSP, I was still skeptical. You see, the more I educated myself, the more that I realized that it was my own personal fear that was preventing me from accepting what the studies were showing, what they've proven. And I became empowered in knowing that while I maintain an undetectable viral load, I'm not infectious, I'm not a danger, and I cannot transmit HIV. There hasn't been a single case to date, and the risk of transmission is so minute, so small, so negligible, that it really isn't even worth taking into consideration. And it's a liberating feeling to know that I have power over HIV. Me, not the other way around. Because you see, when I was first diagnosed, it felt like I had no control over what was going on. It felt like I had been dealt my hand in life, and that was that. And it's been life-changing to know what has now become my motto and inspiration for my blog, Positive Hope. The sky is the limit. There is life after HIV. Being undetectable and uninfectious has helped me become more comfortable with my diagnosis and look at HIV from a different perspective. Maybe a different perspective than I did before. In my mind, it was proof that this virus truly no longer is a death sentence. And it made me appreciate just how far we've come in the last 3 decades. Speaking out about treatment as prevention, realizing that undetectable truly does equal uninfectious, has not been met without resistance in my life. Friends, family, even healthcare providers once in a while cannot comprehend why anyone would do such a thing. So often I hear about other STIs and, well, we aren't talking about those, are we? We're talking about HIV. That's it. Many don't necessarily understand the studies because of the scientific jargon and wording that's used. However, in the words of John Lennon, quote, people fear what they don't understand, end quote. And I'm trying my best to change that. The best part about being undetectable and uninfectious is that it has given my HIV negative girlfriend and I a realistic chance to conceive children naturally. As a heterosexual HIV positive male, that's always been a major concern. Sex is no longer ran by fear, but by passion, just like it should be. And I feel it's important to get this information out there because it helps break down the stigma both in the positive and the negative communities. It also helps couples who are in a mixed status or serodiscordant relationship to have more options, more tools, so they can make an educated decision together about what's best prevention strategy for them. And in turn, it's going to encourage more people living with HIV to start on treatment, which could have a significant impact both on the number of new infections and mortality rates. The conversation about being undetectable equals uninfectious starts here. It starts with us, starts with me, and it starts today. Thank you.